Hey everybody, this is John Marucci. We're coming to you live from Petoskey, Michigan to do a campsite review of Petoskey State Park. So the state park here is in a great location in northern Michigan, right on Little Traverse Bay off Lake Michigan, near the town of Petoskey in Harbor Springs. And it has 178 campsites, 303 acres, four really nice trails, and a mile-long beach on Little Traverse Bay. So a really nice location. Great opportunities for hiking and exercise with the Little Traverse Wheelway close by. So we're going to talk about all these things. Okay, so the first thing we're going to look at in the campsite review is hospitality and check-in, which you give a good rating. Not great, but good. It's pretty simple and very much like other Michigan state parks, where all you do is come up to the ranger station, you go in and check in, usually give your license plate number, and they look you up, and then they give you a slip of paper to put in your dashboard for the remainder of your stay. So that's pretty similar to other state parks and not really a problem at all. The hospitality side, though, we ran into just a little bit of an issue. We ordered an Amazon package, and for an hour or so, they couldn't find where it was once it arrived, and we had to go through a bit of a stress finding. We did end up getting the package, but it seemed like it wasn't quite ready for prime time for them to do packages here, so just be aware of that. Okay, so the second thing we look at is infrastructure and amenities. And all the roads here are paved throughout the park, so no dirt, no gravel. It's really nice and established paved roads. So no issues there with infrastructure. Amenities, however, there's a couple pretty large issues in my mind. The first one is the dump station. So there's only one dump station for 178 campsites, which is a pretty tough ratio, especially if you're leaving on a Sunday afternoon. You may be waiting a while. They really need to think about putting a second dump station in at least and redoing that. And by the way, the dump station, the pressure on the non-potable hose is just almost non-existent, so don't plan on flushing your tanks or anything while you're here. The second problem is the bathhouses. So these bathhouses are getting pretty old. There's one of them especially, one of the showers where the tile's just coming up and it's all rusty. It just almost needs to be plowed over and redone. But they at least need to do a big remodel on the bathhouses. We went for a while during the trip where there was no hot water really, and they did have someone come out and fix it, but it was a pretty bad situation for a few days. And you're paying for that, so it's part of the value proposition. So we can't give infrastructure amenities a very good rating, just a good rating, but not very good. The third thing we look at is site quality. Now the site qualities are actually very good, especially in Tannery Creek because they're all paved. So it's nice to have a paved site. They're not always level, but they are paved, and some of them are nice and shaded. So in a hot day, you're still going to get pretty cool breezes because you're shaded. And some of the sites aren't shaded, but the one we had was shaded and was quite nice. And so the site quality is pretty good in that regard. Now when you go down to the dunes, which is the other campsite, they're all dirt campsites. There's no paved at all. So if you're thinking about having a paved site, you're going to want to come to Tannery Creek. Okay, so that's the site quality, very good site quality. Okay, and the last two we're going to look at is exercise ability and workability. So exercise ability here is outstanding, really excellent. You have four good hiking trails. You have Old Baldy, which is about a half mile, a moderate hike. You have the campground trail between Tannery Creek and Dunes, which is a flat, very easy hike, about a half mile. And then you have the Portage Trail, an easy and a hard trail. The hard trail is quite difficult. We did that just recently, and it's got very decent elevation challenges, just put it that way. So you got to kind of be in shape to do the Portage Trail, which is the hard trail. So be aware of that. But it's good hiking, so really good hiking, even though there's not a tremendous amount of hiking, just four trails, but they are good hikes. And then right near the campsite is the Little Traverse Wheelway, which is 26 miles from Harbor Springs all the way in front of the campsite to Petoskey and all the way up to Charlevoix. So that's a lot of good biking that's all paved. So make sure you bring your bikes if you can, because you can get a lot of fun biking in. Go up to the town of Petoskey. You can go all the way up to Charlevoix if you really want to do a decent bike ride. And we did a lot of running while we were here as well, because the Tannery Creek campsite is just a little bit away from the Little Traverse Wheelway. So you can hop up there and run, and you can get good runs in while you're here. So have to give it very high marks for exercise ability. And finally, workability. So workability here is really outstanding as well. This is, as far as I'm concerned, is some of the best AT&T bandwidth of any state park that we've been at. We've had an amazing, like, almost 56 megabytes down and almost 3 megabytes up just with the AT&T phone. When we put the Wii Boost on the phone, it even gets better. It's 68, almost 69 megabits down, and 13 or so megabits up, which is fantastic. So if you're thinking about working, this is a good place to work from remotely. And that's one of the reasons we've come back here for a few years to work remotely, because it has such good bandwidth and it's reliable. Just a couple other things to mention about the state park that we haven't so far. They don't have a general store here, which I think is a big miss. They really should think about putting a general store out here somewhere where you can get some pop or ice cream or pick up a t-shirt or whatnot. But you can walk down to the city of Petoskey, which is only like 2.5 miles, and shop a really nice, quaint little town, and has very good shopping and restaurants. And one other thing is just down the road a 0.5 mile is a grocery store, so it's very easy to pick up groceries and bring them back to the campsite. So anyway, that's the overall. We'd give it a good rating, not an excellent or very good rating, but a good rating. And the only reason that is because the amenities really need a lot of work. The bathhouses, which you're paying for, they're just not really up to snuff and need to be redone. So anyway, this is the review for Petoskey State Park. Hopefully that was helpful. Again, this is John Marucci. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. Feel free to subscribe. We'd love to have you on the channel. We love making these videos for you. And if you hit the bell icon, you'll get an email each time we put out a new video. Anyway, John Marucci, thanks for watching. Have a great day.